We're here today as part of the series Switch It Up to meet with Chef Sandro Romano at the Modern in the center of Manhattan. This restaurant is actually just near to the MoMA. Let's see how we made it to New York.
So we're here today at the Modern in Midtown Manhattan, and I'm very glad to have with me Sandro Romano, Chef de Cuisine at the Modern. Sandro, thanks very much for having us.
Thank you.
So Sandro, you grew up in Switzerland and you came to New York in 1999.
Yes.
I wonder, what was it that made you come to New York?
Well, I guess at one point in my career and my life, I hit a kind of a plateau where I had a lot of desire, but not necessarily a lot of options. Professionally and personally, actually, and I work in Lausanne, in Lausanne, different places in Switzerland, but I wasn't really sure that I wanted to set somewhere for the future. And so I desire my desire to be more to explore the options was to come in New York. I knew the city a little bit, came a few times before, and in 98 when I came for the third time, I realized that it was a place that I wanted to explore and experiment. I think it's always an experiment to come in New York. It's probably what drives me, because I knew that whatever I was doing, it was okay, because here you don't fail. You just try to do things, and it was very important for me to get hooked on that and trying to do something.
You concluded your formation in Switzerland, and I wonder, how does you growing up and having the formation from Switzerland influenced you in the way you work here with the people,
yeah,
and how it influenced your work at in the kitchen,
yeah,
like your dishes?
Well, it's interesting enough, I think it's only after that I realized I was fortunate actually to have being a bilingual and double nationality in a sense, Italian and Swiss, and from the French part. So all that blend actually was very fertile. Later on, I was very able to understand different culture and to be very comfortable with different language and culture. So for me, to navigate between different flavors and region was just, I would say, normal for me. I was just familiar with. So when I came to New York, and New York is based on this patchwork of different culture and the religion and all that. So for me, I was very at ease just to be here and just to go to the market, go to different restaurants, Asian or more Mediterranean and North and Spanish. The Spanish culture is big in the US, and that was definitely a great seed for me to grow here.
What would you say makes the Modern special? Why should guests come here to visit?
Not only because I guess it's a beautiful place in Manhattan. It's very peaceful with the park. It's kind of timeless also, so you don't feel like you are looking at your clock. There's actually no clock at all. And I think the cuisine is just amazing between classic and modern. We're not trying to give you the wrong message about who we are or who we are not. Like, it's something very clear when you come here that we respect the guests, the experience. And I think the whole service hospitality, the price range, the environment makes very unique. It's very unusual to be in New York where you are introduced to a very chic, sophisticated environment. In the same time, I don't think the staff and the cuisine makes anyone uncomfortable.
Okay.
So I think that's very, very important to at least come once at the Modern and come back for sure.
Well, now one last question. Would you mind taking us for a tour?
Of course.
Okay, thanks very much.
Thank you.
So I'm here with Sandro, and we're going to make a tour of the Modern. So where are we heading first?
That's actually a great place to be here, because you have the opportunity to see the garden, you see the fine dining, the dining room, la salle à manger.
Mm-hmm.
You have also the casual, but the word casual at this point is... So we can't call that a bistro, we cannot call that a brasserie. So we use the word casual. It means like it's less... We have a private dining room where we have the opportunity to do an amazing situation with this room, like we can really customize. So there's a lot of TV channel, sport events, CNN, a lot of different fashion that they can customize this room the way they want.
And where is your part? Where do you work?
I mainly spend time on the fine dining,
yeah,
kitchen,
mm-hmm,
and supervising also the private dining room. When it comes to the bar room, when we opened, I was supervising also the bar room,
okay,
and now it's kind of like on their own in a sense. So we're kind of like, again, the roommates things, like they do their things, we do our things, but we definitely brother and sister, like we just connected every day. I'm always checking on them, what's going on, that they're really able to really do the full day of cooking and managing on their own. Okay, so today we're gonna plate and explain our amuse-bouche, that is a Spanish mackerel, escabeche, that is a pickled preparation. In Italy also they have a scapeche. It's basically something that is very ancient. It's a marinade fried fish that is served cold. So for us, for our preparation, we have Spanish mackerel from Atlantic, a beautiful fresh mackerel. At this point we fillet, remove the skin, fillet it, and we coat it with cornstarch, and then it's fried. At this point we put in a hotel pan, and we do ramps, that in French la des outres. So we pickled with a mixture of spices, vinegar, and white wine. At this point, when the fish is fried and marinated for a few hours, it soaks the acidity and the flavor of all the spice, herbs, and ramps. And we end up after having a beautiful product that is almost like a preserved mackerel, preserved fish, and it's right here. We have amaranth seed that we blanch and quickly pan fried, so they get very crunchy. So it looks a little bit like eggs. That was the idea. So we actually cover a little bit the mackerel with the seed of amaranth. So here we have an emulsion of egg whites and mint oil. So we do our own mint oil right here. We beat the egg white only, kind of mayonnaise style, and we finish with the oil. So we still have like an emulsion, pretty light, very fresh, that we put on the bottom of the dish. The whole idea to have an amuse-bouche is to welcome the guests at the table, but also to give us time to get going with the menu. It has to be something that is pretty neutral, in a sense, like there's not too much dairy, not too much nuts, there's not too much thing is going to offend the guests, so it's going to maybe say I don't like that. So we try to be creative with those restrictions, in the same time make sure that we do something that is kind of like everybody's going to enjoy very much. In the winter we will probably do a soup, something warm. In the summer it would be something like very refreshing. At this point, when we have the emulsion on the bottom of the plates, we can add a piece of mackerel right here. After, what we have here interesting is we wanted to use the liquid of the that liquid actually that you have right here, but to use that liquid in the plate, it will be just not very elegant. So we thought actually to use carrageenan, that is a seaweed extract, and we can actually do sheets. So we can use actually the liquids of the pickling liquids in a different form. So like that we can actually have the flavor. It looks interesting, modern. After we use a little bit of Aleppo on top. L'Aleppo is, in France they use cayenne, in Italy peperoncino, in Syria of the city of Aleppo they have the smoked pepper. And after we just top with a little piece of rams. And voila, that's our amuse-bouche, Spanish mackerel escabeche.
So that was it. Again, a big thank you to Sandro Romano for having us today. And a big thank you for all of you who watched the Swiss series Swiss It Up. It was the last episode and we really hope you enjoyed it and you know more about Swiss cuisine. Have a nice day and thank you again.